National Taco Day is this week. Actually, it's Thursday to be exact. We have Aaron Gardner here and Chef Carlos Franco from Chevy's Fresh Mex, right?
That's right, that's right.
And you're going to teach us how we can all make great tacos at home.
We are.
All right.
We definitely are.
How do we start?
Well, we start with some fresh ingredients. The best way to make a fresh taco is with fresh ingredients. Uh-huh. So we have our fresh salsa here, which we make fresh daily on our mesquite grill. We grill all of our ingredients on a mesquite grill for a unique flavor.
So that's at home, too. You can grill your own veggies.
Yeah,
at
you
home.
Sure can. You sure
all
can.
Right.
You can grill them at home. It gives them a nice roasted taste to it. Mm-hmm. We also use our chipotle aioli over here, which Carlos has prepared for us to give it a little kick. That is mayonnaise, chipotle, some kosher salt and lime juice. It gives it a nice little...
easy to make. So yeah. It's just these ingredients right here, and you mix them together.
Yep.
Absolutely.
Just mix them together, and it gives your taco
plain
a little kick.
Mayo.
Absolutely. So we're going to make the taco in here. So we have the flour corn tortilla. What we're going to do, we're going to put some lettuce.
Uh-huh. A little cabbage shredded in there.
Yeah, absolutely. And we have two choices of meats in here. So we have our fresh-made salsa chicken.
Okay, now how do you prepare that chicken? Because I want my chicken to look like that at home.
Absolutely. This is very easy. So we have a shredded chicken with a roasted homemade salsa.
Uh-huh.
And we put some onions, jalapenos, and cilantro to make a nice flavor.
Do you do that before you roast the chicken or afterwards and then let it marinate?
We roasted our salsa first and then we mix it together.
Before the chicken is cooked?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay.
So then we're going to place some pico de gallo and cotija cheese. So.
All right.
This is how a taco should be. This is very easy to prepare.
Now, I notice you're using flour tortillas.
And we also can use our crispy corn tortillas. So this is very easy to prepare as well. So.
All right.
Okay, so what we do here, we put our unique chipotle aioli. We put our one of the meats in here, which is the...
What kind of meat is that? Ground beef. Uh-huh. With some grilled veggies in there?
The spices and fresh veggies.
Okay.
So we put some lettuce.
So, Aaron, what is Chevy's doing to celebrate Taco Day on Thursday?
There's no better way to celebrate National Taco Day than free tacos.
Okay.
So go ahead and go to our Facebook page on Chevy's and like us on Facebook, and we'll email you a coupon for a free taco. You can choose from our three signature tacos, either our original chicken salsa, our picadillo beef, or our slow-roasted carnitas.
All right. And then is it too soon for cranberries and the drinks already?
It's never too soon for margaritas.
Really? Well, just margaritas. What kind of margaritas are these?
We have our cranberry margarita here, which starts October 8th. We have 1 week left of our watermelon, which is one of our most popular margaritas. So try to get out there on National Taco Day and enjoy your last chance at a watermelon margarita. We will switch over to cranberry. We also have a prickly pear and your standard regular margarita here. And nothing goes better with tacos than margaritas.
All right, so really quick, one piece of taco trivia. Wow us with your information.
One piece of taco trivia. In case you were wondering what the largest taco ever was, it was 1,654 pounds of taco. So it takes a small village to finish that off, but it is definitely a big taco. So one other thing you might not know is the crispy taco actually originated in the United States.
Oh.
Down in Mexico is mostly soft tacos. So,
yes, corn tortillas. All right.
There's some trivia
Aaron,
for you.
Carlos, thank you so much. Enjoy National Taco Day this Thursday. Thanks for joining us. We'll be back for the KCRA 3 News at noon.